You research your topic, find citations and references, formulate some powerful observations, and finally, deliver it into a well-written document. Now you need to create the packaging that will attract people to make you feel good about the entire presentation. It is time to cover this by designing style sheets. What? No. Not designer sheets of style. I mean Microsoft Word style sheet design. This is how you make your written works present well and serve your intended purposes. Most folks have used MS Word their entire life, but did not pay attention to these heading 1, 2, and 3 icons in the menu bar. Within 15 minutes, you will change your writing proficiency by light years. Now, we make sense of it. We start by stepping back into the Pacific Lamprey Habitat Analysis document to apply the style sheet. For now, we will focus specifically on the headings for the document outline. That is heading 1, 2, and 3. You can take these further down through 4, 5, and 6, but you do not need to walk through all those lower levels unless you get the document that really justifies it. A lesson for headings applied to your documents is to know that when you make a document title, it should be exactly that, your title. It is not heading 1 of the entire document. After the abstract and introduction, which are each heading 1, you will find additional document structure, like the table of contents, list of figures, list of tables, and acronyms used. That is some of the housekeeping details, and they are numbered in the III III I section. The document has not started here yet. The first header titles of this document begin with the abstract and introduction. Those were requested by my client, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, so here they are. After that, you will see the analysis data and tools as a heading 1 level style sheet. That means that everywhere you see a heading 1, you will see it as font Arial, left justified, 14 point, and bold. It is always kept with the next line's paragraph. You'll never see a heading 1 on the bottom of a page without at least 2 lines of the paragraph that follows it. That makes the heading 1 happen. You will apply heading 1 by placing your cursor on the paragraph you want to change and click in the home ribbon, styles panel, heading 1 controller. Just like that, the heading 1 settings are applied to this paragraph. The next incidence of a heading is for heading 2. Here, it is existing geospatial data. Notice there is some text between heading 1 and the heading 2 titles. It makes it cleaner to read as you see the linkage from one level to the next. You also see how the list of data is used to put into a numbered list with brief discussions for each topic. They are all mostly similar in length and content. Scrolling further down, you will see derivative data and analysis, with another brief introduction to the heading level, then a list of data as articulated through Esri's ArcGIS program. This is further described as we enter another Heading 2 level, Analysis Software. Again, a short paragraph introduces what this section addresses as it leads to Heading 3, GIS Software and Operating Systems. A total of 6 Heading 3 entries are made, and each heading was followed by a description of the title applied. This is an important moment of this document management effort. When you create a heading title, you need to make at least one paragraph of introduction to why it is there. If you inserted a heading 2 below it, make more than one heading 2. Do not create heading 1, then heading 2, then heading 3, each with a single topic, only to be followed by another heading 1 entry. That is not the way to make documents. Anything that is inserted like that could have been included all within the heading 1 label. You made a subheading, so it is expected that you will have at least 2 subheadings under the main topic label. Use the heading format to introduce transitions within the document of subheadings, each supporting the next higher level in the outline. Your document will read better, flow logically, and become the masterpiece you intend it to be. I want to step you into the document mechanics portion of this exercise. Place your cursor on one of the Heading 1 paragraphs. Notice I said paragraph? Yes, this applies to the paragraph you are formatting. It is not a single word or character definition. It is for the entire paragraph. On the home ribbon, you see the panels for clipboard, font, paragraph, styles, and editing. We have been selecting from the Styles panel. This panel summarizes what is individually controlled on the font and paragraph panels. Folks most likely recognize these settings when words are modified. Now we take it into the Styles panel. With your cursor on one of the paragraphs where Heading 1 has been applied, select the Heading 1 label, right-click the mouse, and select Modify. This opens the control panel for how all instances of Heading 1 will look. You set the font name, size, alignment, and spacing right here. Do it once, and it will be applied to all instances of this heading within this document. When you click the Format Controller, it drops a menu where you can see the familiar interfaces for font and paragraph. You also see some additional labels for tabs, border, language, frame, and numbering. The best advice I offer you is to spend some time to experiment with these settings. You will spend an hour or two and then use these for your lifetime as you write new documents. Now, to give this some more meaning for you, open the paragraph option from the Format Controller. It opens the familiar paragraph settings, but I want you to open the second tab of this applet, Line and Page Breaks. When you select the Widow Orphan Control, it means the single lines of the paragraph will not be separated from the rest of the paragraph at the bottom or top of the page. The Keep with Next checkmark means the heading will always appear on the same page as the next paragraph below it. You can also select the Page Break Before box to always put a page break immediately before the paragraph. Watch out with this setting. While it may seem like a great idea for Heading 1, make sure you use it as intended and do not create super short sections with only a title and a couple sentences until the next Heading 1 is applied. You will make all these settings for each heading you use. When you create Heading 2, it will be based on Heading 1, so you use the same font and color, maybe intended a little more, but remember to keep with Next. As you set up your normal paragraphs, these are the text you write for the content of your document. This is where you apply the font, size, alignment, and space after settings. It makes your document flow easily from one paragraph to the next. You will neither require this to be kept with Next nor have a page break before each paragraph, but you would require Widow Orphan Control to be turned on. The other paragraph setting I generally use is a space after setting of 6-point. If you're one of those writers who always puts an extra return between your paragraphs, then this is the setting to change your life. No, seriously. When you slap in those extra paragraph returns, your pagination always makes a fit to place your page breaks incorrectly. Use this space after setting to make it all perfect every time. Do it once, and you'll never look back with regrets. Well, all right, now we take this one to the bank. Go to the first section where the table of contents header was listed. I deleted the table of contents, so now we make it recreate. Place your cursor in the position where you want the new TOC to appear. Click on the References ribbon, far left side of the panel, click the table of contents. The top two options are what you want. I like the longer name, so I use the second one on this list. Bang! Just like that, your TOC is perfectly inserted into your document, showing all the levels you identified and the page numbers where they were applied. As you edit this document, you will change labels and the page numbers where they appeared. When you do this, the TOC you just created will not change automagically. Nope, you need to implement one little update to make that happen. On the TOC list, right-click and see the applet appear. Select Update Field. Click the radio box telling it to do it all or only page numbers. I generally do it all, and within seconds, it is all updated. The table of contents gives you a solid foundation to start applying these tools across all your professionally written documents. Wait a minute, they are all professional, aren't they? Oh, of course they are. Show some respect for yourself. Show it by applying these tools to the documents you prepare. In the next video, I will take these heading tools to apply to specific heading numbers used for figures, tables, and equations. It all comes together right now.